This is sort of the new thing. Miguel, you spend a lot of time with people who want to see legalized marijuana. They want to see how Washington State and Colorado, how it goes there to figure out how they're going to make up their mind. You spend a lot of time in Colorado. Is this helping or hurting that state?
Well, it's helping. I mean, I think that any time that you have conservative politicians coming out and even saying decriminalization, which, let's be honest, decriminalization doesn't mean legalization. That just means basically not putting people in jail for it.
It's very, very different from
what Colorado and Washington State are considering right now. So, to me, you know, politicians do this all the time. They try to split the hair, and Perry is someone who's maybe looking at a presidential run, and he's looking for some ground where he can sort of placate both sides.
Yeah. And Trish, you know, you've spent a lot of time covering this.
Hang on, Kevin.
You spent a lot of time covering this, and your documentary, Marijuana Inc., ahead of its time when it came to talking about the business of marijuana and legalizing it. Do you think that this country can afford not to do it?
Well, it is a tremendous business opportunity for sure. I mean, you think about the tax revenue, Don, that Colorado is going to collect here. There's a 25% tax that they've instituted on all recreational marijuana. They're estimating that they're going to get about $70 million as a result of that, off of about $600 million worth of sales. So, I mean, it's tough because you don't want to say we're just doing this for economic reasons, but at a time when states are really hurting and they're needing this kind of revenue, this is obviously a very attractive opportunity for them.
Kevin?
It's actually not. Trish, you know this as well as anybody. For every dollar in alcohol and tobacco tax revenue that states gain and the federal government gains, it costs us 10 in social costs. You know, the last thing that came around that we said, oh, this is wonderful tax revenue, was the lottery. The last time I checked, the lottery has not solved public education crisis, which is what
it was supposed
to do.
Here's the problem, Kevin. People are going to do this regardless.
Sure.
It happens. And so all the money that you're spending,
but when it's legal,
running around
it's
trying to
promoted.
Lock up people, now you can spend a lot of money actually working on education programs. You look at Portugal, for example. Portugal decriminalized all drugs about 10 years ago. So all the money that they spent locking people up and putting them in prison, they've taken that and put it into education programs. And what they've seen is that drug usage, especially among the young, has declined. So that's one sort of case study.
You're quoting the Colorado, it shows overwhelmingly are older people. It's a baby boomer generation, and people think, oh, it's going to be these teenagers.
Older people, there's a lot of tourists as well. I'm looking at new numbers now out of Colorado, and a lot of it are tourists. A lot of these medical marijuana places said they moved 60 to 65% of their product over to the retail side. They should have done 80 or 90%.
Listen, no one wants a 2-year-old to go to the ER, but is that a sort of straw man argument? Because, you know, young people get a hold of their parents' alcohol and they end up in the hospital. Young people get a hold of their parents' prescription drugs and they end up in the hospital.
Right. Here's the thing.
You're exactly right. I couldn't agree with you more.
Yeah.
Those are legal drugs.
Yeah.
Don, those are legal drugs you're talking about. Why would we want to expand access and availability for another legal drug? It's been a disaster for you.
But one of the advantages in this is that if you are taxing and regulating it, you have the ability to avoid the 13, the 14-year-old getting access via the underground market.
Do
the idea here is to get rid of the underground market.
And speaking of that, there is some news today because the Attorney General Eric Holder says that legal marijuana sellers should have access to banks. How important is this to the business of pot, Trish?
Oh, this is critical. Actually, this is absolutely, positively critical. I can tell you, Don, I've been out in Colorado, and I've been with some dispensary owners, and the measures that they have to go through to deal with all their cash, because they can't actually use a banking system. So how do you meet payroll, for example, if you're only operating in cash? And it's interesting, they even go through elaborate measures to make sure that this cash literally doesn't smell.
Yeah.
So in other words, you buy some pot, they take it, they put it in a bag, and then they put it in a sealed room, because if the bank smells it, and it'll smell like marijuana, because all these dispensaries do, then the bank says, no way, you're done.
How important is it what Rick Perry had to say about marijuana, that it should be left up to the states? Because sometimes I feel like we're having these conversations in a vacuum or 5 years later than they should have been had, because clearly the public wants this to happen. And if the public are voting for the people to be in office, then they're going to vote for who the governor is and who makes the law.
I think for now it's probably fine. Going forward, I think it's going to be a problem. We have a situation now in Kansas where a woman apparently died in custody after being arrested, denied her medical marijuana. Whether or not this was the actual cause of her death is not very clear, but this is the sort of stuff that is going to be very difficult to regulate on a state-by-state basis going forward. Yeah. All the states around Colorado.
And let's be quickly, very Kevin. Clear about what Rick Perry said, first of all. Yeah, we do need to make that distinction between decrim and legalization. Rick Perry is talking about justice reinvestment in drug courts, which they've invested in. That is very different. Treating this like a health disease, which is what we all want to do. It's why Patrick Kennedy has joined me and people on the right and left, why the AMA stands really on one side. Yeah. And Trish, you're right. This is a big business. There's a big tobacco-like business that's looming in front of us, right?